My dad supported the Air Force and the Army, and then when I had the opportunity, I said, boy, I want to travel the world, and so I joined the Navy.
While you're deployed, you have a strong sense of community through your command. You're eating together, you're working together, you're fighting together.
It was some of the best times, some of the best experiences, some of the best friendships out of there.
Your command's gone, your greater sense of mission is gone, and you're kind of lost.
Who knows what some of these guys go through as far as the, you know, the visuals that they've seen, right? I mean, the things that they've had to do.
This whole identity of who you used to be is not there, and your support structure isn't there.
You're thrust into a community where you've got to decide what you're going to do and how to navigate a system that maybe you haven't traditionally had to do for some time.
We know so many other soldiers that have no jobs, that are on food stamps and waiting in line at the food banks.
Even good people fall in between the cracks.
This should not happen to soldiers who've served our country.
It's easy to say, listen, I've committed my life to serving this country, but now what? Now I'm out. Everything I knew was that. Now what do I do? In 2006, when my best friend got deployed to Afghanistan, I essentially decided to write a memoir. Tommy Franks ended up endorsing it, and General Corelli endorsed it, and a number of others. And that put us on a mission of just really being an advocate for the military family.
Found out that I was going to be getting out of the military, retired, but about a year sooner than I was expecting.
Now you're kind of in this really archaic system that's confusing and redundant with paperwork, and it's incredibly difficult to navigate, and it turns away a lot of vets.
Our goal was to be a hub, a trusted place for people to come to, that if they ran into issues, that we knew where to direct them so that they could get the right proper help.
It's really nice to have an advocate like Mike that knows what programs work well, what will be the best fit for you, and what will get you on your feet running again.
We saw so many families that they came home and they didn't know how to reconnect, or they would have, you know, moments of just meltdown in their kitchen because they wouldn't know how to fit back into their families.
Our goal is, man, can we help you through that? You've got a support system. We're there to help you. A buddy of mine came back from Iraq, and he divulged to me that he went over there solely on a second deployment to commit suicide. And that was the first time, I think that was the first time that that issue drove home to me. It's that sense of finding hope again, and that's what we want to help these families find, is what is that hope? What is that next thing for you to grab onto? What is that next thing? Can you find hope in your relationship, in your marriage, in your friendships, and not fall into isolation? If the family remains strong, then our country remains strong.
In a nutshell, I don't know where we would be without the help of Mike.
I think we're one of many. And if we can be a voice, a catalyst to help other people get involved in the issue to help solve it, then great. That's our purpose. It's my duty.